So we've looked at how Gauss-Jordan elimination can be used to solve a linear system with one right-hand side. Now we're going to move on and show how we can actually simultaneously solve with a number of right-hand sides at the same time. Let's have a look at what we mean by that. So here we have two linear systems. Notice that the part on the left, which leads to the matrix, is identical for both of them. And when we have different right-hand sides. Now, obviously, we could go through Gaussian elimination or Gauss-Jordan elimination for each of the right-hand sides, but then we would be recalculating a lot of computations. So what we can do instead is create an appended system where we append both right-hand sides, and that's equivalent to working with both right-hand sides simultaneously. So how does that work? Well, we compute our first Gauss transform. We apply it to zero out these entries right here. And notice that we're applying the Gauss transform to both right-hand sides simultaneously. Then we move on and we compute multipliers and insert those into the Gauss transform, negated, of course, in order to eliminate these entries right here. We apply them to the appended matrix. And we get this right here. And notice that now we've introduced zeros right there as well. Then we move on. We compute one more Gauss transform. We apply it. And we end up with a diagonal matrix and multiple right-hand sides that have been updated. And you can imagine that we could have even more right-hand sides. And then we want to multiply by the inverse of the diagonal matrix that's sitting right here in order to multiply rows to put ones on the diagonal, and this is what we get. And lo and behold, these are the solutions to these two systems with which we started. So what's going on here? Well, we've progressed up to some point where we have introduced zeros above and below the diagonal up to this point right here. We then want to introduce zeros in the next column of the matrix. For that, we compute multipliers that we negate. We apply this to the matrix as well as to the right-hand sides. And here we try to depict having multiple right-hand sides. And then we move on. So we can give these different regions names. So this now becomes U01 and L21. That's this part and that part. This here is the diagonal matrix that's sitting right here. And notice that the right-hand side now consists of a number of columns, which we can think of as a matrix. So therefore, we end up with different pieces of the matrix right there. And then when we apply this Gauss transform, what we get is this right here. And now what we want to do is choose our U01 and L21 so that we introduce zeros right here and right here. And when you do that, you get this. And what you notice is that the updates really happen in rank one updates of these regions of matrix A and B. So here then is an algorithm that works with multiple right-hand sides simultaneously, where we view the right-hand sides as a matrix B. These are the updates that must happen. Here you notice that we are computing the multipliers. Here we update the regions of matrix A and B. That corresponds to this right here. And then eventually we come back and we set these regions to zero. Now that leaves us with a diagonal matrix eventually. So then we have to do a separate sweep where we go through and we scale the rows of B by the inverse of the corresponding diagonal element in A. And we set the element in A to 1. So that A is left as an identity matrix. So in summary, Gauss-Jordan elimination is an alternative for solving AX equals B, where really we are working with multiple right-hand sides at the same time, creating multiple solutions corresponding to each of those right-hand sides at the same time.